Methylene diphenyl diisocyanate, commonly called MDI, and its derivatives will react with water, including moisture in the air, polyol, or any alkaline compound such as ammonia or detergents. Because of this reactivity, these materials may present potential physical and health hazards during handling.
In this hazard communication section, we will discuss the physical characteristics of MDI, the routes of entry, potential health effects of overexposure, first aid, and the personal protective equipment required when handling MDI.
Physical and chemical testing provide both manufacturers and customers with information necessary to protect employees, as well as information pertaining to the physical properties of the material.
The physical data can differ depending on whether the MDI material is polymeric or non-polymeric.
Additional information can be obtained from the safety data sheet, SDS, or the technical data sheet accompanying the product.
Physical data testing has shown that liquid MDI may solidify at certain temperatures, depending upon its mixture. Specific information on your particular product can be obtained from the product's SDS.
MDI has a flash point greater than 300 degrees Fahrenheit. Thus, it is not ignited readily under most conditions. However, it will burn if exposed to an ignition source at or above the flash point temperature, and fires are possible if proper care is not taken.
The Center for the Polyurethanes Industry developed a document for the purpose of determining occupancy classifications involving the storage, use, and handling of MDI. Refer to this document on polyurethane.americanchemistry.com for additional information on how MDI is handled under the International Fire Code.
Viscosities of the various components of MDI are product specific. Please consult the SDS or the technical data sheet for the product being handled. Testing has also shown that MDI is reactive with certain types of materials, including water. When MDI reacts with other materials, heat and carbon dioxide are generated. Over time, this can create excessive pressure in closed containers.
To reduce risk of unplanned reactions, it's extremely important that MDI not come in contact with moisture or water. Other reactive agents include, but are not limited to, ammonia, polyols, alcohols, amines, caustic soda, and caustic potash. MDI is typically a clear, water-white liquid. However, some polymeric and MDI prepolymer mixtures can be colorless or water white to dark brown. Let's take a look at some of the potential health effects associated with MDI overexposure.
For a chemical to cause health effects, it must make contact with or enter the body. The three primary routes of entry through which this can occur are inhalation or breathing, skin or eye contact, and ingestion or swallowing. Be aware of these routes of entry when handling MDI. If overexposure by any route occurs, seek immediate medical attention.
Due to its relatively low transport temperature, 80 degrees to 115 degrees Fahrenheit, MDI has a low vapor pressure that greatly reduces the potential for exposure by inhalation. Exposure to MDI vapor at elevated temperatures or during spraying applications may cause irritation of the eyes, nose, throat, and lungs.
Difficulty breathing, tightness in the chest, and coughing are also symptoms of overexposure. In most cases, these symptoms will disappear within a few hours after the exposure takes place.
Overexposure to MDI vapor may cause respiratory allergy or sensitization. Skin contact may also be associated with respiratory allergy. If sensitized or allergic to MDI, a person may react to extremely low airborne concentrations of MDI.
Move anyone who shows signs of irritation or asthma-like symptoms to fresh air and seek immediate medical attention. The onset of these symptoms may occur immediately or be delayed. Therefore, medical personnel may be required to observe overexposed individuals for several hours after exposure. Liquid MDI can be irritating to the skin or eyes. Skin contact may result in redness and may also cause skin sensitization, an allergic reaction.
Symptoms such as redness, itching, and rash may occur when a sensitized person contacts MDI. If a person has become sensitized, the most prudent course of action is that the individual no longer works with MDI. For skin exposure, first wipe off the liquid, then wash with a polyglycol-based skin cleanser or corn oil. Soap and water may also be used, but may be less effective. Always refer to the product's SDS. Remove any contaminated clothing.
For larger exposures, use an emergency shower. Eye contact may result in redness, but tissue injury is not expected if MDI is immediately and thoroughly rinsed from the eyes.
OSHA requires an eyewash station or safety shower be located in the immediate area where MDI is being handled.
For eye exposure, flush the eyes thoroughly with running water. Many companies flush exposed eyes for at least 15 minutes and then seek medical attention.
Although unlikely, accidental ingestion or swallowing of any chemical could occur. MDI has a low potential for toxicity by ingestion. For ingestion of MDI, do not induce vomiting. Seek medical attention immediately. Eliminating exposure at the source will prevent these potential health effects. As with other chemical shipments, hazard communication information is typically attached to containers either by a warning label or tag.
If additional handling information for MDI is required, please refer to the manufacturer's safety data sheet. Everyone involved in the handling of MDI must be equipped with the appropriate personal protective equipment. This includes appropriate impervious clothing, such as chemical protective suits, chemical splash goggles, and chemical-resistant gloves and boots.
Harmful vapor concentrations of MDI may occur at elevated temperatures. Approved respiratory protection may also be required when handling MDI at elevated temperatures. To prevent overexposure to airborne vapors, refer to applicable regulations for permissible exposure limits for MDI. In the U.S., air concentration limits must be below the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, OSHA, permissible exposure limits.
The American Conference of Governmental Industrial Hygienists, ACGIH, also established threshold limit values for MDI, which are commonly referred to. The odor threshold, or point at which you can detect MDI with your sense of smell, is above the permissible exposure limit. Therefore, odor should not be relied upon to indicate the presence of MDI. MDI has poor warning properties. Monitor the workplace periodically for MDI vapor. If you can smell MDI, you are exposed above the permissible exposure limit.
In this hazard communication section, we have discussed the physical characteristics of methylene diphenyl diisocyanate, the routes of entry, potential health effects of overexposure, first aid, and personal protective equipment necessary for safe transfer operation. If you have any further questions or are unsure of the actions required of you, ask your supervisor or team leader or contact the product manufacturer.
For more information on the topics covered in this section, consult sources including the following literature developed by the Center for the Polyurethanes Industry: Guidance for Developing a Written Respiratory Protection Program, Guidance for the Selection of Protective Clothing for MDI Users, Guidance for Working with MDI and Polymeric MDI, Things You Should Know, Occupational Hygiene Air Monitoring for MDI and TDI Guidance.